Chapter 5. North Indian Plains, Central, Eastern and Delta. The third part of the North Indian Plain is Ganga Plain. The plain is drained by the Ganga and its tributaries. It forms a 1050 kilometers long east-west corridor between the Himalayas in the north and the peninsular plateau in the south. Then, physiography. The Ganga belt is the world's most extensive plain of uninterrupted alluvial formed by the deposition of silt by numerous rivers. The major rivers in this region are the Ganga, Yamuna, Chambal, Gomati, Ghagra and Kosi. The main crops grown here are rice and wheat. The other include maize, sugarcane and cotton. The low-lying flood zone of the rivers in the upper Ganga plain is known as Khadar, which has newer alluvial, while the uplands are called the Bangar, which have old alluvial. About 30 km wide, the Bhabar belt that lies to the south of the Shivalik range has a dominance of boulders, gravels and sand. The rivers descending from the Himalayan slopes disappears in this belt and reappears in the Tarai belt that is located to the south of the Bhabar. The Tarai is the marshy land. The middle Ganga plain has a unique homogeneous physiography. The region is less elevated from the sea level. The fluvial landscape is characterized by natural levees, meanders, and oxbow lakes. The word Duar means door. The foothills of Jalpaiguri and Darjeeling districts are called the Duars, which forms the gateway to Bhutan from India. The middle Ganga plain is drained. The rivers Shon, Kosi and Ghagra in the middle Ganga plain are notorious for the havoc of floods and frequent change in their courses. Then climate. The temperature reaches to 48 degrees Celsius in May and June. The hot lew during summer season is unbearable. Most of the rainfall comes from the Bay of Bengal branch of the monsoon. By December, winter sets in and the mean minimum temperature in January falls to 4 degrees Celsius. The middle Ganga plain is a transitional zone. The lower Ganga plain experiences a hot and humid climate. The temperature starts rising in March and causes Kala Baisakhi, heavy pre-monsoon rains that play havoc with life and property in the region. Then soils. Throughout the region, alluvial soil is found. In the upper Ganga plains, the Bhabar track has sand and gravel while the Tarai has sandy clay with humus and moisture. The newer alluvial soils of the Khadar are highly alkaline, but the older alluvial soils of the Bangar are mature. The middle Ganga plain has immature alluvial soil. A poor drainage causes accumulation of sodium salts that renders the soil infertile. The soils generally lack nitrogen and need manure and fertilizers. The lower Ganga plain consists of laterite, red and alluvial type of soils. Then, natural vegetation. Bhabar and Tarai tracks have more area under forest than the plains. The Bhabar and the Tarai have a dominance of sal and semal trees. The western, drier area has shisham, babul, kair and simal. The uncultivable tracks have bargat, peepal, imli, mahua, neem, babul, etc. In the lower Ganga plain, three types of natural vegetation are found. Mangroves or sundri are dominant in the delta region of West Bengal. Tropical evergreen forest occur in the Duar tract in the north, which contains sal and shisham. And the deciduous forest in the western park have teak, shisham and bamboo. Then population and settlement. The Ganga plain is one of the most densely populated areas of the world. It occupies 9% of the total area of the country and accommodates 23% of the population of the country. In the Upper Ganga Plain, compact settlements are found in the Bangar region of the plain that have good facilities of irrigation and transport. Lucknow, Kanpur, Allahabad, Meerut and Agra is a historical city. In the Middle Ganga Plain, Patna is the largest city. Varanasi is a religious town in eastern Uttar Pradesh. In the Lower Ganga Plain, Kolkata, Howrah, Durgapur, Siliguri are the major towns. Then economic development. The alluvial plain with adequate rainfall and enormous water resources has encouraged people to develop agriculture. The crops include wheat, gram, barley, oilseed in winter and rice, maize, sugarcane, bajra, jawar in the rainy season. Groundnut, sesame and mustard are dominant oilseeds in the plain. Sugarcane is the most important cash crop in the region. Agriculture is the mainstay of the economy in Middle Ganga Plain. Rice and wheat are the important crops. Then mining. Coal occurs in Birbhum, Bardhaman and Bankura. Iron ore is found in Damodar Valley region. Then industries. The Ganga Plain is leading in agricultural production. And the industries are mainly agro-based like sugar, oilseed, rice, cotton and jute mills. Leather industry has flourished at Kanpur and Agra. Blanket and carpet industry is developed in Mirzapur, Bhadohi and Varanasi. Silk saris are manufactured at Varanasi and Bhagalpur. Barauni has a petrochemical complex and a petrol refinery. Fertilizer industry is located at Barauni. Iron and steel industry is located at Kulti, Barnapur, Asansol and Durgapur. Chittaranjan manufactures locomotives. Haldia has a petrochemical complex, an oil refinery and a fertilizer plant. Then transportation. Ganga Plain has flat even land, that is why it is very easy to construct road and railways. So transportation is well developed. All major cities have facility of air transportation. Then Ganga Delta Plain. The Ganga Delta has the shape of a triangle, which is also known as a fan-shaped delta. It is the world's largest delta. It is known as the Ganga Brahmaputra Delta or the Sundarbans. The principal ports are Kolkata and Haldia. Red and red-yellow laterite soil are found in the delta, which has large amounts of minerals and nutrients which are good for agriculture. A large number of people live in the delta. Most deciduous forest is found in the delta region. Thick stands of tall grass known as cane brakes grow in wetter areas. The Sundarbans freshwater swamp forest lie closer to the Bay of Bengal. Animals in the delta include the Indian python, tiger, leopard, Indian elephant, crocodiles, which live in Sundarbans. Large number of cheetal are found in the Sundarbans. Then, Assam Plain. The Assam Valley or the Brahmaputra Valley is the eastern continuation of the Great Plains of India. It is a well-demarcated physical unit in the northeastern part of India. The valley includes whole of Assam, which is drained by the Brahmaputra River. Geologically, the valley is formed by the deposition of alluvium. Assam is endowed with petroleum, natural gas, coal, limestone and feldspar. This plain region experiences tropical monsoon climate with heavy rainfall and high humidity. Thunderstorms are frequent during afternoons. Assam is one of the richest biodiversity zones in the world. Many are protected as national parks and reserve forests. Kaziranga is a national park for Indian rhinoceros and it is a World Heritage Site. The white-winged wood duck is a state bird of Assam. The valley is known for orchids. Tea plantation have flourished in Upper Assam, and today Assam is leading state in tea production in India. As per 2011 census, the population of Assam Valley was 3.12 crores. Assamese and Bengali are the major languages spoken in the region. Assam culture is traditionally a mixed culture due to the assimilation of ethno-cultural groups in the past. Bihu is the most important and common and celebrated all over Assam. Durga Puja is another such festival. Then, natural hazards and environmental problems. Ganga Plain is frequently flooded, but with torrential rainfall, rivers overflow and a large area gets flooded. Brahmaputra River is flooded every year, resulting in heavy loss of property and life. Andhis, Lu, hot winds are common in May and June. Salinity is another problem faced by the farmers.